Springtime comes and the leaves are back on the trees again. The snappers are harder to see, my friends. Weeding out your weekend. Summer comes, gravity undoes you. You're happy because the lovely way the sunshine bends. Hiding in the deep end, weeding out your weekends. Candy left over from Halloween, a unified theory of everything. Love left over from lovers leaving. Books they all know they're not worth reading. It's not for the season.
Hello, chat. Let's fade that out. Thank you, Jeff Tweedy, as always. How you guys doing? It's good to be back on another Sunday evening. It's gotten really nice out. Sorry, I thought the song was still playing, but I thought you guys could still hear it, but the mixer isn't popping up, so it's all good. Yeah, it's gotten really nice out over the past week. Not that you would know it from yesterday, when it decided to get really fucking cold again after we turned the heat off. Such is life. But yeah, how you guys doing? Thanks for showing up. Happy 70F. Let's see, how hot is it here? Let's check really quick. Let's see what the temperature is right now in my neck of the woods. It is 74 degrees. So 74F to C. That's a solid almost 24C for those across the pond, or indeed above us. It's nice out. It's very, very nice out. I actually have my window open, but unfortunately I can't have it open because I live next to a highway, and that means that you guys will hear nothing but cars, and you will think that the world is ending, unfortunately. It's just the fact of the matter. Sometimes I'll be on calls with Kebby, and that's exactly what will happen. She'll be like, ooh, what was that? And she's like, it's just a truck. It's just a truck. But of course, everything sounds like a nuclear bomb passing across the highway when it's through my mic, so such is life. 10C sounds like something crashing into the house, she says. You heard it here first. Not gonna rant as long as I did last time before we start the game, but I do want to give a hearty you're an asshole to the guy who installed all of the electrical receptacles in my house, because they are all incredibly loose. We had a term in Milo Hacks, in the Guitar Hero community, if you've ever played Guitar Hero 3 or Clone Hero, we would call the space you had to hit the notes, the timing window, we would call it Whale Pussy Engine, because you had like 2 seconds to hit every single note. And these are Whale Pussy outlets, because you plug something in and they fall right out. And the only reason I bring that up is because I realized that I could slim down my streaming setup a little bit and not have to use a power strip if I just use my little travel adapter, because the only thing that I'm plugging into it are USB devices. Literally, the entire house is filled with these loose receptacles. Also, for whatever strange reason, there happens to be one UK outlet, and it's partially painted over. It's in the living room. It's just a random UK-shaped outlet just sitting there. We've never used it for anything because nothing uses this plug here. So I have no idea what the hell is going on with that, but yeah. So I realized I could, you know, skip the power strip situation. But the problem is that my little travel adapter is so fucking heavy that it falls right out of the socket. Thankfully, that outlet is normally where I plug in my heater. So quite literally, I have a bulky, you know what a travel adapter looks like. It's a big box, and it has, you know, mine has USB ports, but usually they just have like an outlet, kind of a funky looking hole set up on the one side, and then on the other side there's, you can either plug in adapters to be able to switch out the different plugs, or mine has them zipping out with little slides. Cabby can vouch for it because I use it quite a bit over there. It is very, very nice. But it's so heavy that it just falls right out of the receptacle. So I have it propped up between the wall and my heater, and that's currently what the two devices that enable the streaming setup are plugged into. So it worked. I'm glad it worked. I always have to play with everything on my streaming setup for like 10 fucking minutes before I get anything to show up, which is unfortunate, but that's okay. I do want to show you guys something, though, before we get started. This is something that I have been working on all weekend, and actually, if you include what I was working on last weekend, then technically call it like 8 or 9 days or so. I do see that everybody is showing up with purple names in the chat. I don't know if that's a new thing or what. On the stream, not on the actual chat display in Streamlabs, but on the actual chat replay window that's embedded in the stream, everybody's name is purple. I think that's cool. But anyway, so I haven't mentioned this on stream just yet, and I really haven't mentioned it anywhere outside of the places that I hang out now, but I am now a contributor to a little thing called, and let me get it pulled up, ProtoWeb. ProtoWeb. And this is the cool, spooky back end that nobody else gets to see. You're not going to see anything special. This is effectively the same thing that you see when you actually log into ProtoWeb itself. But what ProtoWeb is it is an HTTP proxy. So one thing that doesn't really get utilized much anymore is proxies. So back in the day when everybody had garbage internet, you could connect your browser to a proxy as opposed to just directly to the internet. And if a site happened to be like in the proxy's cache, you would download that copy as well, and it would be much faster. These days, there's not a whole lot of reason to use proxies. VPNs are not the same thing as proxies, but they're a similar concept where you're funneling your web traffic through something else. So if you need something a little bit more contemporary to compare it to. But ProtoWeb realized that you have all of these old browsers that can't do anything anymore. And they realized, well, they all have proxy support. So what if we had copies of websites sitting on our proxy server, and you could connect your old browsers to this proxy, and you would be able to browse old websites that have been lovingly restored by a group of people who don't get paid to do a single bit of it, all that good stuff. But I've been a contributor now, because the moment that I saw that they were accepting people to contribute stuff and restore websites, I was like, oh, I've done that before. I would have to pull it up right now, and I just don't feel like making you guys wait, but when I ran VDU, one of the sites that inspired the Valve Developer Union was a site called The Forge, which was a documentation reference site for WorldCraft, and WorldCraft being what eventually became Hammer being the level editor for Source Engine games. Well, originally, when it was for making Quake levels, they called it WorldCraft, and then when Valve bought it and included it with Half-Life, it was still called WorldCraft, but eventually they rebranded it to the Valve Hammer Editor, and WorldCraft and Hammer, at least Hammer, you know, the 4.x series, nowadays, I think they have a version for Source 2, and it's completely different, but they're pretty similar, you know, and I would look through all this stuff, and the site only half existed, and I was like, well, that's a shame. But then eventually, on, funnily enough, a Duke Nukem 3D FTP server, they had a backup of the FTP site that this Forge site relied on for all of its downloads, and I was able to make a full restoration of the website. So I've done site restorations before, and I was like, oh, I could do something like this. And so I decided to sign up and contribute to ProtoWeb, and I'll show you two of the sites that I got done. One I got finished last week. I had a sitting on the back burner since March, and then I finished it over the span of like 2 weeks. And then the other one was one that I just finished up last night, or actually today, excuse me. I was working on it last night, though. Just to give you an idea of the kinds of things that ProtoWeb is for. So, first things first, IMAX. So this is the actual original IMAX website from 1998. And the grab was in really great shape. There was very few things that needed to be restored on this. But now you can go ahead and you can click through it. So, and of course, the site looks exactly the same. And this browser window is 800 by 600. So you're looking at it in the correct size that it would have been if you were browsing the site back in the day.
And you can go see, like, for example, you could see the IMAX ride film stuff, which is where they put you on this, like, platform with seats on it, and it can, like, move around, and the action wraps around you, and it's effectively a theater park ride, but IMAX has never shied away from doing that sort of deal, you know? And then there's also sub-sites for, like, different attractions and stuff. So we have the Race for Atlantis sub-site, which is just so quality. So quality. And like I said, this is basically what you would be looking at if you went to IMAX.com in 1998, you know? And ProtoWeb even has a 56K proxy that lets you... that throttles your connection and lets you see the site at the speed that you would have in 1998, assuming you even had a 56K modem. A lot of people don't realize 56K was fast for dial-up. There were people who connected with 33.3 kilobit per second modems and 28.8 and, like, all sorts of even slower stuff. So, you know, I'm totally nerding out right now, but there is all sorts of stuff that got backed up here that I had to restore. And I spent a lot of time fixing up server-side image maps and all that good stuff. You can go browse this right now. This IMAX one has been published. I quite like, I think it's this page, where they just got someone's dad, and they dressed him up as, Atlantis is Greek, I think? The legend, I mean. They dressed him up as Neptune. They dressed him up as King Neptune. So there we go. There he is. It's totally not someone's dad. But if you want to know even how well captured the IMAX site was, if I pop it back to here and I go to the corporate page, check this out. IMAX's financial results from the 90s were saved. And yes, you can view these. Yes, you can in fact go back and see that the IMAX Theater Corporation reported earnings of 14 cents a share for the second quarter of 1997. If you wanted to, it's there. It's on ProtoWeb, which is just awesome to me. I love that it's just so much, like, randomness that just got perfectly saved. So that was a fun restoration. And then, and this is the really exciting one. This is the site that I just got finished today. Bleem. Check this out. So, if you don't know what Bleem is, you're probably familiar with the concept of an emulator if you're watching this stream. So, what Bleem was Bleem was one of the original PS1 emulators, and you're probably thinking, oh, what does that mean, like 2003, 2004? No, this shit was competing with the PlayStation 1 in 1999. You could, on your Pentium 2, with a Voodoo 3 card, run PS1 games if you had Bleem. Like, bonkers. Bonkers stuff. So, this is a totally restored version of Bleem.com as it was in the year 2000, which, yes, you can, in fact, go to the website. This is not in ProtoWeb currently, but it will be by tomorrow. And then go to, like, the download page, and, in fact, download Bleem from ProtoWeb. The Bleem update is on ProtoWeb now. It's not just the website, it's the actual executable. You can download it, and you're not going to be able to see the pop-up, I don't think, but it's on there. Yeah, you're not going to be able to see the pop-up, but there is a save dialog that just showed up. So, that's cool on its own. Here's where it gets crazy. Check this out. I go to the game list. There is full Bleem compatibility data saved for every single game up to 1999 or so, with some exceptions, but almost 1,100 games that you can check exactly how they ran with details in ProtoWeb for Bleem. So, you know, you click, yeah, let's do Einhander. This is not a web page. Just to be clear, this is not a static web page. That's a CGI script that I wrote by hand to re-inject all of the game detailed game information for compatibility, injecting that back into the results page. So it's not a static page. It's PHP that's actually taking a CSV file, so comma separated values, CSV, taking the data and injecting it into a page. The database that it wants for this detailed 2.cgi doesn't exist anymore. I recreated it for ProtoWeb. So all of this works. So you can go find any game. Let's do the classic. I don't know if Savannah's here right now. There we go. Let's do Spyro the Dragon. So you can see right there, it wants to go to detailed 2.cgi game Spyro the Dragon and product code SCUS94228. That's not a page that exists. But the CGI script, you click it, it takes those variables from the URL and injects it into the page from a CSV file. And I made this work again. So that alone was like, oh my God, because I've never worked with PHP before. I've never done any of that kind of stuff. But it worked. But I didn't just stop there. So we already have, you know, it's dynamic. But let's not stop there. Let's have the full Monty. How about actual search results? So check this out. So we go back to the Bleem site, and it uses frames, which is why it all loads in differently. It's delightful. 2000. Go to the game list. Now chat, let's get a little bit of audience participation in there. Give me a PS1 game. Give me a PS1 game, and I'll put it in. Check this out. We got a Tony Hawk. All right, let's do it. I don't think LSD Dream emulator is in there. I will check, though. So we do Tony Hawk. Search. Right then and there. Dynamic search out of that CSV file. And yes, you can, in fact, click these links. Yes, Bleem. You can click these links, and they will take you to the actual detailed results page for Tony Hawk, as they were on Bleem's site. Like I said, let me show you one more time so you can see this is not a fluke. I go to the frame. It's a CGI file. It's not a static page. This is happening on Bleem's site right now. And I know that dynamic pages aren't like anything like super special on the internet now, but the fact is that I did not know a lick of PHP before starting this project, and I still don't. But I wrote this, and I made it work, and I was so freaking giddy as I made it work. Because it really did take me a lot of trial and error to, like, okay, first things first, parse the URL correctly. Echo the variables, make sure that I have the variables correct. And then we start doing some logic stuff on those variables, start parsing out the CSV. Eventually rewrite part of it because it's not working correctly, figure out what I'm doing wrong. Oh, it's supposed to be two equal signs, not one equal sign, you know, all that good stuff. We made it work. We made it work. I'm super, super hype about this. Oh, I think DCB wanted Dream Emulator. Let's check that out. Let's see if that's in there. It is not, unfortunately. LSD Dream Emulator is unfortunately not in there. But I will show you something that is cool. It even handles my script. I'll check out Clonoa in a moment. My script even handles if there's no results correctly. Nothing. And it will even say no games in the database met your criteria. Which is just like polished. Super clean. All right, let's check Klonoa really quick, because DCB just mentioned Klonoa. Tris, it's interesting that you mentioned that, because there are people who show up in the ProtoWeb Discord all the time, and they're like, oh, when are you going to do this 2000s website? And it's like, first things first, ProtoWeb, it's meant to be the early web, not the 2000s. It's not a nostalgia product. It's pretty specifically historical project. It's like meant to be like a museum piece, really. But then also, 2000s websites and especially 2010s websites were not built like 90s websites. They were, you know, they're based on databases and CMSs and all this other stuff that you were just not going to get a proper restoration, because with the tools that we have with the Wayback Machine, it can only grab what pages look like to the browser. It can't grab, you know, the database file, because nobody has access to the database. So basically, unless, you know, the data just happened to exist in somebody's backups and they contributed to ProtoWeb, those sites couldn't exist. So it's always funky when people go, oh, why don't you do this 2000s website? Like, literally every single day we get somebody asking, when are you going to do like a 2000s ProtoWeb? That's not ProtoWeb at that point, you know? It's like, I get it. I'm nostalgic for the 2000s too, but like, it's not really the same thing and it's not as possible, you know? Anyway, let's check what the status is for Klonoa. And actually, I might... Yeah, I'll check to see if I have anything embarrassing open first. And... actually, no, it's alright. I can... Yeah, no, that should be alright. So, I was going to show you something else in a moment before we get to the game. But yeah, so... Klonoa worked. See, you were joking. You were joking. But a lot of people aren't. A lot of people legitimately think that we can just do the ProtoWeb magic on, you know, somebody's fucking 2007 blogspot, which is technically still possible, I guess. But, like, it's not going to be long before people are like, when are you going to do the ProtoWeb version of Vine? You know, Vine, it's so old now. And it's like, fuck, I'm ancient. Get off my lawn. Anyway, yeah. So let me show you this real quick. I know, I promise. If anybody's actually, like, really itching to get to the game, I will show you the game in just a moment. Let's go ahead and add one more source. I'll give you a little peek behind the scenes. ProtoWeb, Vine, gross. Interesting. Very interesting. It's not recognizing the Notepad++ window. That's funky. Is it because it was... Yeah, interesting. It detects Discord, it doesn't detect Vivaldi or Foobar. It doesn't detect Notepad++. Okay. Tell you what I'll do. Yeah, that should be all right. That's fine. All right. This is completely ill-advised, but I am going to do it. Don't try this at home, kids. Okay, yeah. Oh, guys. Remember when we did that on a stream like 4 years ago? Give them good suggestions for what to name his city. Yeah, I mean, chat's not going to appear, but that's all right. I'll just make this really quick. Okay. Yeah, all right, this is fine. So now you're seeing my screen, and I know you get the wah effect or whatever. But let me open up Notepad++ real quick, and just let me show you all of the code for what we just saw, just to give you some context. So this... Here it is. This is the database file. This is the CSV file that I was talking about. And they call it CSV because it's comma separated values. So we have as the first, say on the first line right here, first item is the game ID. Second is the name. Third is the publisher. Fourth is the region. Fifth is if it works or not. Sixth is the version of Bleem that it works on. Seven is if it has direct 3D acceleration, and then eight is the any comments for how the game works or what have you. So this is, yeah, almost it's 1,037 lines, and each of these is its own game, or at least its own what's the word I'm looking for? Its own release of a game, you know, for like the PAL version versus the Japanese version, all that good stuff. Peach Town is good. Definitely a good idea. So it takes this, and then there's two CGI files. There's Detailed 2, which is just this, basically just this little bit of PHP, which gets the variable from the URL, loads up the CSV file, and then for each line, it goes, you know, each line in the file looks for the matching game code, and then once it finds it, it breaks it, and then it just puts it into a table. So that's the, that was the easy part. That was the detailed page, you know, for the detailed information. The search one was hard, and don't get me wrong, I'm sure there's somebody who can clean this up, because it's probably not very good code, but whatever, it works. We're doing four searches, so the product code, the game title, the publisher, and the region. So it does those searches, fixes some stuff on the regions, because they're formatted a little bit differently on the search pages. We have a function here for actually searching through the field. It's not fuzzy searching. It's just, you know, it's just a, it looks for the string inside of the string you're actually searching through. So you can do Tony and it will find it in Tony Hawk, for example. And if it doesn't find it, then it'll immediately start this no-go variable and break out of any further searches for that title. Down here, same sort of thing, load up the CSV. It does a for loop through each line. Then it breaks down each line into an array, and then it searches through the what you searched for in the URL. It checks that against the CSV, the array that it just made from the database file. And if it matches, then it'll pump it into an array. I think the correct term is it pushes it onto an array. It'll do that, and it'll do that for each of the games. Then it closes it, and then this is the part where it actually formats it into a page. So if it didn't find anything, no results. If it did find things, then it tells you how many things it found, and then it just, this gigantic mess of nested switches and bullshit like that, that's how it makes the table. So it's not the most elegant thing, and I'm also working with 1990-2000 era HTML, so that's not great either. But it works, and it is very reliable, and I am super, super happy with it. And yeah, I just figured I would take the first half hour of the stream to show you that. It's okay. We'll get to the actual game now. Okay. Sorry about that. We don't have a chat box. We do. Once chat messages start popping in, it'll show up. That's all right. Let's hop over to the bed. Wink wonk. I also keep mentioning, or meaning to mention this, my Sly 2 disc is slightly cracked in the inner ring. So that's cool. It's very comforting to know that this is spinning at probably several hundred, if not thousand, RPM in my PS2, and there's like a visible crack in the inner ring. It's not through both layers of the plastic or anything, it's only through the one layer, but who knows? Maybe this will explode in my PS2 with my head next to it. That would be cool. Let's go ahead and put the disc in. Hello, Redusk. Hello, everyone. Let me just pull up the chat on my phone. And I thank you all for your patience as I worked through that. Although, to be perfectly honest, I think a lot of people who watch me, not everybody, but a lot of people who watch me are maybe more of the technical variety. So maybe there were some folks in there who appreciated the chat, you know, in the chat. They appreciated that. Let me go ahead and pull my own stream up so that way I can monitor chat. Just give me one moment. Oops, I forgot, I'm not on Wi-Fi right now. That's not good. You know, fun story about the Wi-Fi, actually, or about data. Let me make sure that I'm using the correct Sly 2 save really quick. Hold on.
I was actually slightly worried. Because as I mentioned a couple streams ago, I got stranded in Wales for a little bit longer.
I know, horrible fate.
But as a result, I didn't have data for a little bit. And I later found out that it was courtesy of my mom watching literal TV over her data connection for the entirety of the trip. So it was a nice... I don't even remember how much that bill was. What was it, like $140 that month? thank you. I very much appreciate that, Mom. Much appreciated. So I didn't have data, which meant that I couldn't use the phone or anything for like the extra week and a half that I was there. But yeah, so I think about that now every single time that I wind up on data and don't mean to. Yeah, boomer moment, Gen X moment, but yeah, same thing. I'm glad that people like listening to me. I said it before, but if I'm background noise for somebody, I'm happy to be that, 'cause I know that I put on like streams and stuff while I'm playing like Unreal Tournament and shutting off my brain or whatever. You know, Ryan, now that you mention that, I will say I do appreciate soundtracks more. I feel like part of the reason I got disconnected from games is that I would always play with the sound off, which is cool sometimes, but like now it's cool to like have the background noise even as I'm like listening to something else. You know, as long as it's not music on top of music. Yeah. So I went to Wales to go see my girlfriend. That took me from early February into mid-March. And I only meant to stay a month. I wound up staying an extra 2 weeks, I think? Or was it just an extra week? I don't remember. I think it was an extra week and a half. But I wound up staying a little bit longer because I missed my flight by 5 minutes. It was great. And it was an extra like $700 that my girlfriend had to pay out of pocket. Much appreciated, she offered. So yeah, that was nice. Yeah, it was 10 days. It was 10 days. But yeah. I find myself appreciating game music more and more because it definitely completes the mood, you know? And I feel like I get into it a little more when I can just sort of, like, let the music play. Yeah. Extra shipping. Yeah. Hey, sweet. Dude, I fucking love Wales. I miss it so much. Obviously because I was with my girlfriend, but also just, like, you know, all the castles. And I like how much smaller it is than the U.S. You can't walk anywhere where I live. Because it's literally nothing but, like, roads with no shoulder and highways and all that kind of shit. She lives right in, you know, the suburbs of Cardiff. So, I mean, 15 minutes, you're in Cardiff Central, you know? And even if you walk it, it's like an hour. Like, I don't know. That's really nice when you're not used to that at all. I'm sure to people who actually, like, live there, like, it's nothing special. But, like, to me, it genuinely is like, oh, this is so much better than where... Not that where I live is bad. I just don't have a car. I need a car, basically, is what I'm saying. We were, so the outskirts of Cardiff, basically, to the point where it was within a couple stops of Cardiff Central. That's where we were roughly so as to not dox my girlfriend, but yeah, within the region. All right, let's get started with the episode. Jailbreak, Contessa.
Week of data crunching, but I eventually tracked down the location of my friends, locked away in the mysterious towers of Prague. At the moment, they are the unwilling guests of Interpol's most renowned prison warden, the Contessa. While still a criminal psychology student, she entered into a whirlwind romance and married a wealthy aristocrat. Sadly, the union was short-lived, as the general suspiciously died a few weeks after the ceremony. The widowed Contessa
put education she's a widow spider
estate to work by opening a criminal rehabilitation center. Her pioneering use of hypnotherapy has produced some good results and subsequently earned her a prominent position within Interpol. My friends are locked up somewhere in the clinic and are slated for the Contessa's Good Samaritan brainwashing. If I don't bust them out soon, they'll be working a 9-to-5 job selling shoes, and I'll be out 2 best friends.
Alrighty. We are in position to break out Sly and Murray from this. We got some cash. We could buy some gadgets, right? Oh, that fucking alarm clock. Ugh. I forgot about the adrenaline burst is pretty funny. We're gonna buy that later this stream.
I should make my way over to the Contessa's house. Maybe I'll pick up a few leads on the location of Sly and Murray.
Alrighty, so we're going that way. It is pretty fun, though, that you get to play as Bentley exclusively for a bit, because I was praising Sly for this the other day, or last stream, actually. But I just like how each character not only feels different, but feels, like, fun to control, which is not something that you can... Oops, as I almost get caught by the spotlight. You know, you remember the first game, how, like, the driving sections with Murray, fucking terrible. But, you know, every character feels good. Oh my god, you can even hide in the barrel as Bentley, that's funny. And the secret is that they all have weaknesses compared to Sly, but they all have major strengths compared to Sly as well. So, of course, there were times... I guess it's gonna rain, because I'm hearing thunder. So if you hear any, like, thunder, it's thundering outside. But there were moments where I was like, oh, damn, I really wish I had his, sleep darts. Bentley's sleep darts when I was playing as Sly, you know? And then, of course, Murray could walk up to a guard and just, like, clock him. And that's it. So, yeah, Sly is more agile, but he's not the be-all, end-all. They made each of the characters feel good in this game, which is, like, real hats-off stuff. If you hear thunder, there's thunder. I don't know where the fuck I'm supposed to go. You think I can hop? Can I hop over here? No, I cannot. Ooh. Where am I going? There we go. Okay. Because I think this is sort of the spot? Come on. Where are we going? I gotta get my bearings. Oh, right up here. That's right, I was in the right spot. I second-guessed myself.
Aha! The Contessa is out making her rounds. Wait a second. The feathers on my sleep darts vibrate near sounds. If I maintain my position on top of this parabolic dish, I should be able to hear that frequency at a distance. This is great! If I tag the Contessa with my darts, I'll be able to listen in on whatever she says. I might even learn where she's locked up Sly and Murray.
I love it. He's not only super smart, he's also got super hearing. Alright. So I have to hit Contessa with my darts. I'd love to, but she, like, has flung herself out of view. There she is. Alright, Contessa. Stop fucking flinging yourself off the building! My word. Okay, come on. Come on, you fucking spider. It's quite literally a shooting gallery. Come on. Fuck. No. Fuck. There she is.
Claw gun is falling apart. Spy shipments have all but stopped. Ugh. I never would have joined if I'd known it would be this easy to disrupt the plan. At least the Cooper gang is under lock and key. Their lopsided morality flies in the face of man's inherent selfishness. Oh, well. They'll see it my way soon enough.
Oh, you bitch. Doink. There we go. Sorry, there's people whispering outside, which is completely unnecessary.
How come no one ever thought of this before? Hypnotize criminals and force them to reveal where they've hidden their fortune. I'm a genius.
I'm a genius. I'm a freaking genius, CJ. Dude, how was she able to get around so fast?
That blasted Cooper gang. The fat one. What's his name? Murray. Yes, Murray.
Webbs.
He'll be the first to break.
Yeah, I guess. Maybe?
Probing that feeble mind. I can only imagine the wealth that gang has accumulated over the years.
I do wonder where do they put it all? You know, because she's right. The Cooper gang has pulled off some freaking huge heists. So, like, where do they keep it all?
That's like Cooper. Such a complex and rebellious mind. A month or two and all should break his spirit.
Maybe.
Let him squat there week after week. He's seen that the guards along the wall all have motion detectors. There is no escape. Slowly, the reality of his captivity will set in, and I'll get to work on his mind.
They spent it all on drugs.
Inconceivable.
Extreme chat frozen.
She's no healthcare professional.
You're right. It is frozen. Hold on. Let me try to refresh it.
The most heinous crime I've ever heard of. Putting inmates into hypnosis. So they'll tell
there we go, and it all just comes pouring
lid.
Out like drugs hidden in
it
someone's butt.
It dishonors both law enforcement and thieves at the same time. I should get to work and figure out a way to break Sly out of the hole.
Oh, yeah. After Sleep is dead, too, which is really funny. It's like, oh, yeah, we finally fixed the bandwidth issues, and then it goes down middle of the month again. Alright, so we go back to the safe house now. Woohoo! Yeet. Oh man, he's fast. Let me just say that even as Bentley, I'm definitely not stealthy at all. That's okay though, we're very, very close to the safe house. I still feel like the February one? Definitely feel like that one was longer.
Of a control system for the electromagnetic train.
The bandwidth-induced sabbatical. It's like every day. It's like every Saturday after the calls, how we'd be like, all right, everybody, don't talk in the chat. Go live your life. That's what after sleep does every 3 weeks at the end of the month.
Its impact on the prison walls should create a hole large enough for Sly to escape through.
All right, you heard him. Let's go reprogram some computers. Sleep dark. Ooh, wow, that rain is heavy. Yo, I mean, oops.
Nothing like a good.
Hold on, I gotta pause it for a moment. Yo.
Hold on. Okay, that lighting is decently far away.
Just so you guys can... I'm tangled in my cable. Hold on.
Outside. In case I disappear, this is exactly where I went. Power went out. But we should be alright.
It's not windy, it's just thundering.
Oh, listen, joke's on you. I listen to that shit. Okay? Anyway, let's get back to the game.
If everything dips, you know what happened.
Yeah, I mean, I figure so. You live in Wales.
Now the left analog stick should control.
Oh yeah, we got some Robotron going on right here. Let's go. Listen, you guys should know me by now. All of my practice with Geometry Wars has set me up for this exact moment.
I should move the right analog stick in the direction by using both analog sticks at the same time. I'll be able to move and shoot in different directions. That's one down. The train should be picking up speed.
Robotron is awesome. Robotron is maybe my favorite arcade game. No, I still gotta give it to Galaga, but Robotron is definitely second. I forgot. As you get later into the game, there becomes more of these environmental hazards that just quite literally run you over. So that was fun. Alright. Ooh! Can I hit the guy behind him, too? Yeah! Can I bomb them both? Ooh! 2-in-1 special. Yeah, no, the hacking minigames in this one are awesome. Alright. Hit it. Yeah, the rain has calmed down a little bit. It's still audible out there, but we should be alright. Ow. You motherfucker. Precision aiming is a little bit tough because this one has full 360 movement as opposed to the 8-way joysticks that, like, Robotron has, but I mean, come on, I played the tits off Geometry Wars, I got this.
Hello,
I don't know who you are, Power Dragon, but welcome to the chat. I'd say that as in I don't recognize you. Hello, welcome. Alright, so now we're looking for 4 more computers to hack. They should be all along the railway, right? I mean, that would make sense given that we're going to use the trains to, like, nuke the shit out of the holding cell. Yep. There's another one. Oh, maybe you were on one of my streams before, actually, now that we're talking. I'm not, you know what, I played a little bit of Jack 2, and also a little bit of Jack 1. I find, the sort of edgy direction that Jack took kind of, I don't know, it's definitely my least favorite of the three, like, I don't know what you call them, second party games. Like, I loved me some Ratchet and Clank when I was a kid, and I still have my Ratchet and Clank disc. I don't have the box for it, but I have the disc. Maybe we should play that, too. We play the first Ratchet and Clank.
That should speed up the train by at least 50%.
Okay. Now, do I hop through the tunnel and possibly die? Well, I'll wait until a train comes through. But yeah, no, I'd love to play the first Ratchet again. And I do own the first Jack and Daxter, you know? So I could, in all reality, play through that as well. Honestly, it seems like my streams do better when I stick to, like, PS2 games, which makes sense given that most of my audience came from, like, Guitar Hero 2. So... yeah, dude, I love the first Ratchet and Clank. That shit was so fun. The guns were so great. Ow. Like, it was a good time. I almost beat Going Commando as well, but if I'm honest, I don't know, it just felt like it never ended, so I don't remember, I probably still have my save, but I don't remember how far, I mean, I probably did almost beat it, but I never fully beat it. But Going Commando I almost beat as well. Why do I keep walking into fire? Come on, pay attention. Pay attention. Thank you. Yeah. No, like I said, I do remember you now. It took me a moment. You got... oh, fucking trans. You got run over and then he drowned. That's so sad. Yeah, no, I mean, and I never mean it as, like, an insult or anything. Like, oh, who are you? I just mean, like, my life is so crazy fucking busy, and I get distracted by literally everything, so it winds up becoming a case of, like, oh, you know, I forget really basic shit that, like, even, like, my friends have told me.
So, I,
yeah, no hard feelings, hopefully. It's all good. Okay. Now, can I please make it through this train sequence without getting molested by a train? I probably need to, like, step off to the side or something, but, like, where? Where can I... can I step off here? Yeah, there we go. Okay. I figured. There we go. And there's another station. It's true. It's so true. I have, like, a thing... I remember everything except for all the stuff that I should remember. Wow. By the way, this is exactly what studying for your comp TIA plus is like. Just so you guys know. This is what I'm getting certified in.
Yes,
to be honest, that's pretty hog.
Now, on to reverse the field's polarity.
All right, one more, right here. Hit it. You know, I am so glad that I've only ever had sleep paralysis once, and it was when I was really, really stressed. The thing that made it suck, I wasn't frightened, but for whatever reason, my entire body was really, really, like, tired and sore after the fact, like, even through the day. And I was like, why? I guess because I was struggling so much to try and, like, wake my body up? I don't remember. But yeah, it was definitely not a pleasant experience after the fact. Do I just blast through these? What do I have to do here? Ow. Oh, it would help if I, like, pay attention. There we go. Yeah, and then there's the other one. And...
what a beautiful trajectory!
Yeah, no, I didn't hear anything. Oh my god, there was a thingy. I didn't hear anything when I had sleep paralysis. I just, like, woke up and suddenly could not move. And then I, like, struggled a lot, and then when I finally did wake up, when I finally did regain movement, my entire body was just horribly fucking sore. I have no clue what was going on with any of that, but... no, there's no need to follow me. No, there's no need to... No, yeah, it's all good. It's all... I'm one of you guys. I'm a guard, too. Look, I have a bow.
All the guards along the prison wall are outfitted with a motion tracking device. There's no way for Sly to escape. Unless I take those guys out with my RC chopper.
There you go. X. X is how you drop bombs.
Please don't let that be the rotator coupling. Take that.
Okay, so he's gone. Ow. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not trying too hard. I probably should. You know, I am trying to break my friend out of prison. Ow.
That's for making fun of my glasses.
Well, see you in a bit, Ryan.
Sly, can you read me?
How I've missed that sensuous voice of yours.
Save the jocular comments for later. Do you see that hook above the train?
Yeah?
It's your only means of escape. Jump and hit the circle button to grab hold, then swing onto the back of the train. I've already established a safe house and downloaded its GPS coordinates into your binoculars. We'll rendezvous there.
Wow, you've really thought of everything.
Don't I always?
You do.
No!
Thanks for busting me out.
Oh, well, you know the old saying, if you can't count on a friend to bust you out of jail, what kind of a friend are they?
Wow, that's thunder.
True words were never said, wizard.
Aww, he called him Wizard! This is the Wizard. Do you read me? I don't know why I gave him the southern thing, but...
screen dies for a moment.
He thought of everything except for a solid connection to my wall. Because of the fucking power connection thing. Anyway, let's continue on. Wizard.
Okay, here's the situation. I've done some deep database crunching and figured out that Murray is doing time in cell block D. Getting him out is going to be tough. As you know, he's not very light on his feet.
Ouch.
First, we'll need to get Murray into an isolation cell away from the other inmates. Second, I'll need you to get a sample of the Contessa's encryption algorithm. Don't worry, I'll explain later. Third, you'll need to pickpocket a few keys from the Contessa, but watch out for her pack of bodyguards. And fourth, you'll have to deactivate her giant attack robot.
I mean, they've probably figured that part out, right? They've probably known not to, like,
robot.
Let him just punch his
it
way
just
out.
It looks like a water tower. Now, once you've pulled off all these jobs, we'll be ready to make a play for the
not
big
that strong. Well, whose fault is that one, Kebby? She's like, oh, I'm going to make, like, this disappointed dog my background. Oh my god, Sly has so many fucking jobs. Alright, let's start with the easy one.
Okay, Sly. In order to get Murray out, we'll need him to get thrown into solitary confinement. That pipe will lead you to a cell block. Try to locate him and relate the plan. After that, it's all up to Murray.
Alright, I'm headed inside.
Also, can we just, like, take a moment to appreciate how, like, it's snowing? It is so bitterly cold in the, what were they called? The mysterious towers of Pog. It's true.
Murray.
They would have just been like,
huh?
Oh, well, he's a burden anyway. Ah, to be 18 again.
Where are you?
Over here, in the back wall.
Sly! I'm so glad to see you. They've been forcing me to eat meals covered in spice, and I'm feeling kind of strange. You gotta get me out of here.
No problem. Bentley seems to have found a weakness in the solitary confinement cell. If you can get in a big enough fight, the guards will throw you in there. Trust me, I'm speaking from experience.
Well, if you say so, I suppose a powerful force like the Murray
could
take down 50 foes, if I had to.
Excellent. You beat the snot out of 50 of those guys, and Bentley and I will take
it's two penguins doing it. You know, 5 whole ducks, 2 fucking penguins. That's my usual. Hey, listen, you wanted to see Murray get into a fight? They're even keeping score, check that out. Oh man, you know what this reminds me of with the spikes on the wall? That reminds me of Mad World a lot. Oh, I could play Mad World on stream. You wanna see Mad World? I have that too. That game is brutal. And a good time. I'm gonna shit in your general direction. Oh yeah, 17. How many do I have to kill? Sorry, I had to check that out. 20. To be honest, can we just, like, have this be a mini-game? Like, where all I do is I'm Murray and I try to just kill as many guards as possible? Because this is fun. That's, again, that's what I was talking about. Every single character in this game is so satisfying to play as. Like, even Murray. Like, you know, again, given how awful the driving was in the first game, the second game, oh my god, dude, his punches, they have such a good rhythm to them. Doink, bonk, boink, donk, fuck that guy. Destroyed. See you later. Like, just feels good, right? You feel real good. I think 50 is probably the goal of this one. Bring it on, suckers! The Murray! You stop, dude. I don't know. Oops! I was apparently lagging a little bit. Yep, fight with 50 guards. See, Murray was doing good, but then I, like, walked into the spikes too often, so... I'll pay attention. You have to unalive 50 of them. You have to forever sleep 50 of them. I hate YouTube's fucking comment moderation. Just so you guys know, if it was up to me, you would be able to say very offensive things on this stream. Like, things that would get Discord users to frown at you. I don't know. Forever eep the criminals. There you go. That's what we gotta do. That's what we gotta say in order to make YouTube happy. I hate YouTube. All my homies hate YouTube. Things that would get me fired from my job. It's true. Very, very true. I love you guys. I also love your ability to, like, how did Jake put it? Indulge in recreational racism. We're good boys and girls in this chat, totally, which is why I'm, like, massacring a bunch of wolves. I like that there's a spotlight in the corner, and it's so useless. Alright. 49, one left.
Incarcerating suckers! Is that antisocial enough for ya? Oh, what? You gonna throw me in solitary? Bring it on!
Thanks, Murray. Very cool. I don't think there's anything for Bentley to do, right? Nope. So, it's all about Sly. Ooh, glowy pockets. Let's see what you got. Their loot changes throughout the game, too, which is pretty fun. Gold medal. With gift dithering on it, which is awesome. There's one. I just gotta figure out how to get over there. Oh, what do you mean you were real? Definitely didn't see that coming.
Under the bridge feed power to the prison security systems. I'll need to cut the connection to free Murray.
Sounds like a plan. What do you need me for?
As you know, the bridge is heavily guarded.
I hear you. You'd like a little protection while you place the bombs.
That's correct.
Love to help out, but there's nowhere to hide on the bridge. We're totally exposed.
That's true. To fool the guards, you'll need to break those statues and take their place.
I pose like a statue, the guards walk on by, then, pow, I hit him from behind. You're a genius.
That's also correct.
That's also correct. Ah, thank you, Bentley, the wizard. I guess I'm supposed to go up, right? Thank you.
Follow me to the top of the bridge.
Oh, gotta follow him. Where'd he go? Did he bounce up there? I have lost sight of Bentley. I mean, he wants me to be a statue, so I'll just be a statue. Oh, I see him down there.
This bomb's all set. I'm moving to the next stress point.
Dude, it's violent out there. Holy shit. I just need to give them enough space, which means I can get into a fight on the bridge. But you guys gotta realize, I'm not exactly the stuff they take.
Got another one in place. Heading back across the bridge.
Oh man, you know what? I look away for just a moment because I'm playing the game and can't quite monitor chat. And all of a sudden, whoops. All of a sudden, I just see nothing but fucking Mr. Watch.
Shit.
Wait, smoke bomb. Whoops. Let's try this again. Let's be totally stealthy. There we go. No one notices a thing. There you go. They're very inattentive guards. And then yeet. And we'll do it one more time. I feel like it just got darker in the room. Is it because my second monitor went off? Let's try this stealthy approach again. I'm very glad that the UK residents are having a good time in my chat tonight. I will say that Mr. Blobby is genuinely a threat to humankind.
The third bomb's in position. I'm en route to set the fort.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, there's totally, like, bats and shit all around.
Chat is stuck again? Hold on.
By the way, if anybody noticed the stream paused for a little bit, like if my frame rate dropped, it still says that my stream health is excellent, so I have no idea.
Oh, she's playing Roblox. Okay. Alright, I was like, what the fuck is going on with the stream? What?
Well, no, because I saw a Discord message where she was like, got stuck, sad face, and I thought it was something wrong with the chat. I do love it, though. My chat is a congregation place to talk about horrific 20th century British pop culture icons, question mark? I have no fucking clue what you'd call Mr. Blobby other than terrible. Wow. Dude, the lightning is crazy tonight. Oh, we're getting into a big fight with all the guards. I tried my best. Alright, they want me to be stealthy, but that's not my style. Play Unreal Tournament, okay? I'm not known for my, style.
Another one's in place. I'm moving to the other side of the bridge.
Damn, how many bombs do you need to plant, my friend? Shiny pocket. Gimme. I'm too good. Too used to this. Too used to shinies. Oh shit. Ooh, he might be getting a little too close for comfort. Alright. All right. Boom, boom, baby.
That takes care of the power to the security system.
I love how they just blow stuff up and nobody notices. Like, we don't have police reinforcements. The Contessa is not like, what is going on here? Why is all of my stuff exploding? Why did the train just fly across the map into the, whoops. Into the solitary confinement. You know, what's going on here, bro? Everything else is inside the walls. Ooh. Listen. We're all good boys and girls in this chat. We just happen to be playing a game where you bomb things, okay? Alright. It's not us. There's no taking the front door. Set to live chat. I'm gonna check something real quick. Hold on.
Nope. Dude, what the fuck? I mean, if my moderators don't have unfiltered chat, then who does? Is YouTube seriously saying that, like, I don't know. Is YouTube seriously saying that even if you don't have any blocked words, even if you have hold potentially dangerous, you know, racist, sexist, homophobic comments for review, even if you have that turned off, you still get filtered? Like, what is the point? It's either it gets filtered or it's just more filtered. That's genuinely fucking terrible. Hey, Pocket Watch. Yeah, exactly. It's like nobody can quite pick up. I swear, YouTube does this on purpose. It's like an ABXing thing, right? Sorry, AB testing. ABXing is that thing you do when you're trying to check the quality of your audio files. It's like A/B testing it, where it's like, oh, it filters it for some people, but like, what's the ultimate purpose here? What are we trying to fix? And what are we testing? Yeah, no, seriously, again, what is going on? They're doing it on purpose. They're trying to ruin my good vibes. I'm straight up not having a good time. Ooh, glowy pocket. At the moment, I'm just trying to figure out how to get into the walls. Wouldn't let me say Murray Dick the guards. Now it's fine. Like, why? What is wrong with you? What is wrong with you, YouTube? You used to be cool. We used to, like, hang out. And, you know, like, do gay stuff together. And now you're like, you got a wife? And you're saying you're too busy to hang out? And I'm about to get blown up by a tank? It blew me up through the wall. And it walks away. Bentley has erased entire ethnic groups. Dude, I missed something in the chat. You guys are going off tonight. I mean, you're probably not wrong. Probably. Although, I mean, he... alright, oh, it's gonna get me reported for saying. Oh, I see something.
To get at Murray, I'll need you to steal 2 tank keys and the tank patrol schedule off of the Contessa.
No problem. I'm an old hand at pickpocketing.
This is going to be tougher than you think. The Contessa's no fool. Since your escape, she never goes anywhere without bodyguards. You'll have to take them out one by one in order to get close to her.
I should probably use noise to lure them away from the Contessa.
See, this is the part where having the thingy would be great. The USB headset mic. Murray is gay. I mean, Murray is definitely not straight. I don't know if gay for Bentley is the correct word. Now I gotta lure the other one. Yoo-hoo! Yoo-hoo! I mean, it censored Cabby's messages last stream. See, I have no, like, physical, or I guess I should say philosophical problem with turtle hippo love. The thing that I have an issue with is the size difference. Oh, fuck, he's not far enough away. Hello? There we go. Come on. Okay. Huh? Damn it. I'm allegedly autistic. Bentley would die, sadly. I don't know, you guys are bringing up some weird questions. It's raining. This job is, Shit. Pain and suffering. Hey, listen, he has that... I shouldn't feed you guys. I shouldn't feed you guys. Because you guys are the absolute fucking worst. Ow. Ow. I'm gonna lose my channel. Ew. Aflac. Damn it. Here. Keep forgetting I can smoke bomb them. I'm not actually gonna lose the channel, I was just joking around. That fucking wolf is gonna be the death of me. Smoke bomb him. Damn it. Okay. Now, just to get close to Contessa. He's a vulture, not a duck. Birds are all the same. Alright? I do it just to bother you. Alright. I'm gonna be very careful. Yeet.
Who goes there? Where are my guards?
bird racism. I'm doing my best, okay? How's that for recreational racism? Shit. Come on, grab onto the hook. Do we have a view of Contessa, please? She couldn't have gone that far. Oh my god. And I can't pay attention to chat. I can't see chat. I can't sneed. Hang on a moment. He's a vulture, not a duck. Life is pain, chat. Life is pain. Oh, there she is. I see. Whoops. I thought that was a walkway. Watch, I'm gonna run headfirst into her. Nope. Okay, so she's on the other side of the... Wow, this bridge is fucked up. I wonder who did that. I love it when a guard wallops you enough to yeet you. That's pretty great. I still don't know how I'm supposed to get in there. I don't think I am supposed to get in there. But maybe she's on the other side? And I just gotta go around. But that takes me where I was. Whoops. Push bash. Carmelita is weird looking. Alright. And it's not because, oh, thank God, it respawned me right next to her. It's not because she has to be weird looking. It's like, they made her, like, the big angry woman because somebody had, like, a big angry woman kink on the team. Which is, like, I don't know, you do you, my friend. Not mean to grab onto that. Hop the, all right, fuck the bomb. So we have three guards. Three guards to lure. Yeah. You'll see Carmelita more in the next chapter. She's being reprogrammed by the Contessa, and it's pretty kinky. Hello. Okay, so there's a guard. Fuck the spotlights. Oh my god. Be very quiet.
The chat's just terrible now.
Someone just dropped everything in the kitchen. Fucking idiots. Yep, that's perfect. Lure that other guard away.
Why is she a spider? I mean, reasons? Question mark? They made her stacked too.
Yeah, no, birds. Some birds eat spiders, but, you know, contrary to what I said earlier, birds are in fact not all the same. So, yeah, no. Vultures are scavengers. These guys are ducks, though. Just because of Father Savannah. Fuck. Listen, we're all bird racists. It's all good. Okay. Now, where did Contessa go? There she is. Oh, fuck. Forgot about the spotlights.
I'm gonna report your stream.
It's fun for the whole family, okay? Everybody gets something out of it. You guys get to bully me, and I get to say that all birds look the same because it's fun. Whoops. I just hope it doesn't make me fail this mission.
I care deeply about the categorization of birds.
I care deeply about big angry women.
Huh?
Fuck.
Yeah, no, I think you have to be autistic to participate in my chat. Okay, time to go through all that again.
This is gonna take a little bit. That's okay, though. See, I keep saying that Savannah is autistic, but she's like, no, I want it notarized and in writing. And I'm like, well, that's just proof. Yeet.
You guys notice that the frame rate drops dramatically when there's like a spotlight on stream, a screen like this? It's pretty tasty. He's currently editing Hitler out of a photo.
That's a new one for Triss. Usually he's, well, you know. Actually, you all have been making really terrible things lately, if I'm honest. See also that desktop background. Are they far enough away that I can finally... Don't use the roof. There's going to be a guard up there. I love the idea that you're trying to be edgy so hard that you actually un-Hitler. Like, you're now anti-racist? To own the racists? There we go. Am I being too cautious about this? I'm usually guilty of not being cautious enough. Kebby wants me to make the dog picture my stream background. Come on, he's right the fuck next to Contessa. I'm gonna use my smoke bomb, I think. Get right up next to him and use the smoke bomb. Alright, so Contessa is finally alone. Hopefully I don't fuck this up. Thankfully, it does not make you redo the entire mission. They were very nice. Very courteous. Easy does it. Calm the fuck on. There we go.
Huh? They're gone again.
Okay. Now to find her a third time. Or I could just die, frankly, because it respawns you right next. Right next to her, so. That's also an option. See, it's like the Brunko thing all over again, isn't it? You had Brunko, and everybody was like, oh, you know, Brunko, the mass murderer, and now Bentley, the mass murderer. But in a different way. I should also mention that Bentley is probably Jewish.
This stream is going until 10 p.m.
Yes, it is. How long have we been going for? Damn, 2 hours already? And we're not even halfway through? Listen, you guys get me once a week, so it's all good. It gives people more of an opportunity to drop in, too. Alright, come on, let's make this happen. Yeet. Hello.
We have one joke.
We have one joke. One entire joke. And like autistic people, we will say it again. So there's a guy. Went around this way.
Now, Sai is in the...
Listen, to be honest, we've all committed some mass murder in our time, haven't we? Affleck.
Jake demands fresh content.
Maybe if Jake wasn't making the same video over and over again. Ayo! I'm kidding. We love you, Jake.
Cammy trying to get New City's business.
Jake is so shy, and his paws are so sore. Sure. Yeah, listen, you know what? I wanna meet Kyle. I said this earlier in the Sheezy chat. Unfortunately, no one took the bait, but I mentioned outright, New Cities is a scam, because it kind of is. I still want to meet Kyle Drake in person. I want to find him as he's having like a $200 vegan lunch or something. He's like, I don't know, like an hour away from the Himalayas or something. He's on some like bougie vacation. Maybe he's having like
what do you call those things? I don't know, they're not seminars, but they're like, I guess kind of like that, but like for like white people, as if there was a seminar for any other kind of people. I want to meet him there, and I just want to ask him why. Wellness retreat. There you go. Thank you. Thank you. Exactly. He's off on a wellness retreat. He's having his gluten-free fathead pizza crust. I want to meet Kyle Drake and be like, why? Why have you done this to me, Kyle? Come on. Oh, yeah!
What? Huh? Where are those lazy bodyguards? They're all fired.
She hasn't noticed.
Great work. Now we're all set up to steal a tank.
She hasn't noticed. Kimmy, also in the wellness trip. Listen, I am a poor white person, okay? I don't get to go to those. I just go to work like everyone else. Alright, we got one more slime mission. I am white trash. Nah. It was really funny, my sister said that the one time, and I was like, you know, I hate that word. Because we're not. Believe me, I've seen some real trashy people in this area. And you don't quite realize, like, how bad it can be until... Not that I want to judge, because, you know, I'm sure they're fine people, but, like, people who they don't take care of themselves. We'll put it like that. Alright? It's like that old joke. I got summer teeth. What's that mean? Well, some are teeth. Get it?
You still have your own teeth. There you go.
Thank you. See? Exactly. Glad we're all on the same page here. Alright. Where's this last slime mission? Oh, there's two. Well, they're both in there.
Damn it.
How am I supposed to get in there? I still haven't figured that part out. Wait, hold on. No, hold on, actually. Oh, I meant to do that. Oh my god. Stop making noise. What's wrong with you? Fucking bats. I mean, your parents are still together, so automatically that puts you a couple paces ahead of me. Government people hits different. Man, I'm fucking stupid. It's not up this way, although there's always dudes sleeping on the roof. Always. Thank you for the health. I like that there's still programmed spikes. That you could theoretically spire jump on them, but you can't because it's right against the ceiling. Much appreciated, Sucker Punch. Oh, whoops. He saw me. Maybe it's this way.
No, but you should be used to that by now.
You're not very stealthy, no, but I mean, it's not like that's the point of the game or anything, right? Wow. I meant to do that. Maybe this way? Like, there's only so many sides of the prison, right? Eventually, I have to reach the one side where I can actually get in. Oh, duh. That's right. Here we go. A long day. It's always a long day, Savannah. We try our best to run this train. Alright. We are a very accepting and tolerant place. We are all gigantically autistic. And we also like calling Bentley Hitler, I guess. I see it. I see that. Also, do you notice that the werewolves, they actually like will like howl in sadness if you get away? I think that's a nice touch. Finally. Hit it.
Sly, I need your help getting a handle on the Contessa's encryption algorithm.
I'd love to, pal, but I have no idea what you're talking
about. I have no idea what you're All talking right. about. This is Cabby every time she's faced with the coding discussion.
Station? The guard nearby is responsible for its upkeep.
I'm with you.
First, I'll need you to pickpocket his key to the terminal.
Sure, no problem.
Then use it on the security station to set off the alarm.
Hold up. You want me to set off the alarm?
Yeah, set it off. Then clear out as the guard's sure to come running. Once he sees that it's a false alarm, he'll input the code to turn it off.
So you want me to take a picture of the code?
Move to a safe place and get a clean shot of that digital readout.
Should I hit all the security stations out here?
That's right. Once I've got a large enough sample of the Contessa's codes, I should be able to crack her encryption algorithm.
Now, see, you lost me again.
Just take the pictures. I'll handle the rest.
Bless him. He's trying his best. He's not really a techie sort. He's trying his best. Thank you.
Nice work. Now use that key to set off the security station. Okay, now climb to a good spot where you'll be able to get a picture of the security code on the monitor.
Oh god, he just sent Hitler.png. Alright, let me go read it. Yeah, I love it, right? Oh, my legs. Listen, it's very, very secure. Sly doesn't even understand what's going on. No way. All right, you're a monster. That's phenomenal. I cannot wait till I get the fucking parachute. I think that's the next chapter, I think. Or maybe I could have had it already if I were to get all the baubles. Damn it. Should I show it on stream? He worked very, very hard on it, okay? I want to hang it up on the fridge.
All right.
Yeah, we're gonna do it. We're gonna show off on stream this wonderful thing that Kebby's brother has made. Stream fan art. He's a good turtle. He doesn't deserve this. I know I'm far away from the mic. I will come back in just a moment. Need to resize it. Freaking fantastic. All right. 3, 2, 1. There you go. You're welcome. I'll even hide chat for you real quick. He does fit in eerily well, all right? I will give him that much. this is how my channel dies. Alright, you've seen it long enough. Let's get back to the game. There we go.
Fantastic.
Alright, now we are all set on that. He fits in eerily well. Okay, I will give him that much.
That image is a thing that exists.
Oops. I forgot. I need to actually... I do notice that a couple people dipped. Everybody was like, oh, okay, it's that kind of stream. All right, well, I want no part of that. I'd absolutely use snowflakes unironically, because it's a funny word. I mean, they're just, you know, ice crystals. It's not like it's a thing to be ashamed of. That's phenomenal. Again, thank you very much, Tris, for that phenomenal photo. That is sure to get my stream flagged. I can't wait. Oh, maybe this is the follow-up to being able to rotate them in the cutscenes. You ninja spire on something and then you just spin.
Slumps.
Ah, shit. I'm glad to give you it wasn't me who came up with it, but I'm glad my stream was the vector for your continued laughter. There we go. Hello. He's like, oh, I saw somebody. Up in the barrel. Oh, there we go. He forgot all about me. All right, now give me your key. And I gotta lure him away from the station.
Bitler.
Get in position for a good photo. What? What do you mean you can't see the fucking monitor from here? I mean, I gotta... Where am I supposed to stand? I guess up here. What? Because the alarm isn't going off anymore? Is that the issue? I genuinely don't know where it wants me to stand. It is going off right now, you can hear it. What? Do you want me to stand right here? Yeah, that'll work. Thank you. Ah, that's unfortunate. It is kind of sad to hear that, like, you know, that's too edgy, and that's, like, the most basic level of edgy, but, like, it's all good, I do get it. Okay. Round three. Let's... There's the system alarm. Get his key. And I should be able to stand up here. You racist. I mean, I don't know. I get the concern, but realistically, it's fine. Everything is fine. Thank you for the key. I don't care that you caught me. I love that the guards have so little regard for each other that they will literally blast each other with their guns in their attempts to get to you. That is a phenomenal bit. Alright. Okay, so maybe I can distract that guard. Get him away from the alarm system. Ow. Those. I think I know where I'm supposed to stand. Make that jump, thank God. Okay. No, get out from under there. Of course, I can't see it from there. I don't know if I can take another hit. Damn it. So I really don't want to have to repeat more of this.
Welcome back, Ryan. How you doing?
Okay, thank God. Alright, back across town. Alright, maybe I should be less sloppy this time. Satisfying. If you hit him early enough, oh my god, now they're all turning into werewolves. Jesus. Oh. Not very stealthy.
Bentley got IP banned on his favorite form.
Is Bentley me? Whoa! Did you see that bomb? That was impressive. Alright, now I just gotta figure out where it wants me to stand for the alarm. Hold on, I can hop up here, right? I can hop on this. Another classic sucker punch move, where that should be something I can climb on and I can't. There is no justice in the world. Yeah, okay, that's doable. Here's the guy with the key. Thank you. Ow. Okay, alright, whatever. Fuck you, smoke bomb. I do like that. You can just, like, fart smoke in a guard's face and he doesn't remember a thing. I think it's an amnesia dust or something. Okay. Now let's make this happen. Hop up here.
Oh, motherfucker. It's Sly's weave smoke.
He gets smonked out. Okay, let's try to be quicker. hop. They do give you a lot of time, though, at least. Which is nice of them. So I should be able to just... Damn it. Yes, there we go.
Okay, that should be enough code. Nice work, partner.
There we go. Okie dokie. Now, there's one last slide jump, I think. Where, though? I think it's inside the prison again. Sorry, not on my A game tonight. I think we have all had a bit of an evening. Okay, so I forgive you. You forgive me. We're a happy family. There we go. Here's how you get in. Okay. Yep. One more sly one. This is the giant death robot one, right? I don't know why we're not having Bentley do it. If it's the giant death robot one. Oh, make that jump. No. Do I forgive Bentley? I never had a problem with Bentley. Listen, people want to cancel me too, okay? I get it. I sympathize. At least they're actually interacting. Bentley riled the crowds with his rousing speeches. Huh. Bentley would have gotten hired under Operation Paperclip. That's all I'm saying. That hurt. Bastards. How the fuck do you get up there? Oh, there's another hook. You know, maybe it would help to look. I'm a little tired tonight. I'm tired, EP. Okay? Okay?
With all due respect, it looks an awful lot like a water tower.
Don't be fooled. That's what she wants you to think. If we try to free Murray while that thing is operational, why...
What, we'll have plenty of fresh drinking water?
I'm serious, Sly.
Of course. I do owe you one.
The lightning rods around the prison are designed to draw lightning strikes away from the water tower. And... giant attack robot.
Yeah.
By turning the wheels on the rod, you should be able to redirect the electrical current away from its ground wire, rendering it useless. Follow the lightning strikes to locate all five rods.
Okay, so you want me to break the ground circuit on all these lightning rods so that a bolt will strike and destroy the giant attack robot posing as a water tower?
Yes.
That's an accurate summation.
Oh dear. Alright.
Get clear where the lightning rod starts to glow red. That means a lightning bolt is on the way.
Oop. So what, do I just turn each one once? I'm not a fan of these kinds of bulbs. Yep.
Nice work. That lightning rod is out of commission. Look around for lightning strikes to find the other.
Committing more war crimes, as always. I can't wait to see the look on Sly's face when he sees that fucking water tower turn out to not be a water tower. I believe that. It's 2 a.m. I am so sorry. I can't wait for the paraglider either. God, it sucks trying to navigate these fucking levels without it.
Sly Cooper 5. Well, first off, welcome to the chat, Digital.
Second, to be honest, I'm happy pretending that it was a trilogy. I'm very, very happy pretending it was a trilogy. I do apologize to Kebby, though, because it is late, and she does have school in the morning, which means she's going to either, or both, be very, very tired. Or miss the end of the stream. Kinda sucks either way. Alright, thanks for showing up, Dragon. There's no real way for me to back out here, is there? I guess I just gotta start these streams earlier. I was like a big preamble, and that means, you know. And then we start a half hour in. Or, I don't know, maybe I started earlier. I'm glad you're enjoying it, my love. If you do need a dip, though, I totally understand. It is late. It's late over here, let alone for you. And I'll just, you know, we'll finish this up and know, call it there. These do only happen once a week, which is, you know. Man, they don't even give you waypoints to which ones you did and which ones you didn't. It's kind of unfortunate. I got the one in the center. And I think I got the two that were outside the station. Oh, I should be able to climb up there. Hold on. Alright, you can stay a little longer. That's cool. Did not get this one. Good. Let's make this happen. That is another one destroyed. So, I guess you just follow the lightning. Wherever the lightning is striking is the one you go to next. That would make sense. They're very logical. I gotta go the long way around. Okay, dude. Yeah, that's the thing. They get the sugar-free kind, it's not caffeine-free. They got uppers, downers, and all around these over there. No, I got that one. What? What the fuck? Sorry, I looked back up and I'm on a completely different wire. The targeting system in this game is very slightly janky. Yeah, it would have to be this one, because that's the one the lightning is striking. Damn it. It's okay, just shake it off. Walk it off. She has to get her autism accreditation, accreditation, though, before she can confidently say that she has it. Right, okay. I remember this part. Can I just climb up here? I have autism, quote unquote. Okay, let's be smart about this. Wait for the lightning to strike it. Boom. Now we go up there, turn one, hop off it. There's the lightning strike it. Hop off it. Man, we can do the third one. There you go. Alright, attack robot time.
Like I said, I am attack robot!
See? You never doubt him. Never doubt him.
Thanks to your recent efforts, we're ready to attempt a Murray rescue. I call this plan the Trojan Tank. Step one, we use the Contessa's keys to steal one of her tanks. I'll jump in and drive while you keep out of sight by crawling underneath. With some luck, the guards won't notice anything out of the ordinary and open the prison gates for us.
The Murray Rescue.
We casually roll in and then blast
Sounds
the security
dirty.
Doors to Murray's cell block. Once inside, you'll need to improvise your way up to the guard control center and open the doors leading down to solitary confinement. Let's hope Murray hasn't cracked under the Contessa's hypnosis.
Okay, so we're starting his battle this time.
Okay, Sly, I'm heading out for the tank.
They always have such elaborate plans. Into the tank I go.
I'm inside the tank, increasing the ride height on the treads.
As the guard watches. He's like, should I do something?
Crawl underneath this thing and let's get moving.
He's in the tank now, can't do shit. Neener, neener. He just walks away. That is a guard that doesn't get paid enough.
I can't see you down there, so try to keep up and stay out of sight.
I do like the potential of Sly's hands and, in fact, entire body getting run over by the tank treads. Not possible, of course, but it's a fun idea. See if they fall for it. Oh yeah, they will.
Suckers.
This is like the Sly Cooper version of Three Kids in a Trench Coat. Two bros in a tank. I don't remember the exact wording of the vine, I'm sorry. 6 feet apart because they're not gay or some shit like that. I don't know.
Go on ahead, I'll catch up.
Oh, these fucking bomb spiders, dude. Just a couple of guys
What's
being
next?
Dudes.
Well, that should be the guard's control center. But to be honest, I'm not sure how you're going to get up there.
Don't worry about it. Thinking of my feet is what I do best.
Murray, however, is the gay one. Yes, correct.
Most of the security went down when we cut the power on the bridge, but a few lights seem to have a backup generator. Be careful.
Listen, I will be stealthy, no worries. I'm so good at being stealthy, okay? See? So stealthy. So stealthy. See, nobody saw me. We are just
just so, so secret. Nobody would notice that.
Still stuff being posted in Somnol. Can't see in there. I can barely see in my own chat. Here we are. Oh, you motherfucker. I like that I can climb onto the dumbbell table. That's pretty cute. These jail cells seem to be more of a trap, if you know what I mean. Maybe this is like a like one of those play jails. I think they call them sex dungeons. I don't know. I've seen weirder shit in the Sly universe, okay? And I don't judge. Alright, I'm even in favor of turtle hippo love. This game, what about the femboy type of trap? My lawyer advises me not to answer that. The duck can't fly. Aww. Ow. Giant spiders. I didn't know this took place in Australia. Thank you, very cool. Oh, I guess there's actually nothing useful in there.
There are no
ducks in this level. Don't be bird racist. Alright, we are so inclusive. Alright, I'll do that in a moment. But he's got shiny stuff on him. Oh, yeah. Alright.
Okay, I'm running your algorithmic code decryptor. You see anything happening down there?
Success! We've got access to solitary confinement.
Hot stuff. I'm heading down.
Head through the gate. I don't know, I guess I just hop down here. Oh, I think it's this way. Yep.
My call-out post is already like 2, 3, 4, 7 pages long. It's fine.
Oh, that looks bad. I've never seen Murray like this.
He's got the shakes. It happens.
All twitchy and bug-eyed.
You said Murray was being forced to eat spice, right?
Yeah, he said he was feeling weird.
Well, he's wearing it out all right. I doubt he even knows we're here. Clearly, we're going to have to lure him out of that cell the hard way.
He's tweaking.
The hard way?
Such is life when you have, you know, drug addiction. Because you couldn't get your turtle hippo love.
And he's already in an agitated state. So if we turn them all on at the same time, Murray's sure to become wildly hostile and probably break down the door.
How do we turn on the hypno boxes?
The power switches are all defended by laser barriers.
Twink Raccoon gets topped by Bear Hippo.
System from my terminal down here. That should give you access.
See, this is why you should have left a half hour ago, Kevy.
How about old Murray? He's looking really bad.
Aw, they truly do care about each other. I wasn't paying attention. What am I supposed to do? Some with the hypno boxes, right? I can't whack them.
Seven people watching.
I hope you're enjoying this. And as always, chat, if you're there but you're not talking, do let me know. I'd love to hear what you think. Turn on three hypno boxes.
Yeah, tell me what you think of this twink raccoon getting topped by this bear hippo.
Cause that's what this stream really needed. That's what this stream really needed. Alright, so they... So, Svanna says try climbing, maybe. Oh, I see. Hey. They are. And like I said, they're kind of kinky.
Okay, I'm hacking the laser barrier.
All right, we're hacking the system. Does that mean... Oh, yeah. I'm the world's most all right Geometry Wars player, and I'm here to say... Finally, something I'm good at. I am hacksawing the mainframe. Just like that.
Flip the switch to turn on the hypno box.
There we go, now I can turn them on.
What's that sound? Angry. Get gone.
Get gone? More like get got.
I'll take care of the laser wall.
All right, round two. Got this. Okay, fine. If I really have to take you out too, I can.
I'm a little teapot, short and stout, tip me over and I'll smash up everything!
man. Oh, fuck. As I fall off the cliff and die. Alright, we got one more to go, guys. And then Murray is gonna top this twink raccoon. Or something.
He's so angry. Oh, motherfucker.
He's so angry because he, I don't know. I don't know why he's angry. Can anyone tell me? Someone in the chat wanted to fill in the blanks for me. It's late. I got work in the morning. Alright, round three. I'm telling you, I am very okay at Robotron 28-4. So I am built for this. I like that the music gets faster, that's pretty cool. Let's see some hippo rage.
Let's do it.
Oh, there you go. He just... Yeah, his spice rage. Oh, ow. Bro. And boom.
My head.
He's like a real hippo.
What? Is this heaven?
Sorry, pal. You're no angel.
Just take a few deep breaths and try to center your thoughts.
Okay.
What's with all the racket? My conscious mind is a wreck. I ought to... The weak-minded hippo is free!
The weak-minded hippo is free!
Perhaps it's time to reevaluate some life choices.
I'm serious. I managed to keep this half of the clockwork heart safe. It was hard to hide from the Contessa! She's getting away!
Murray, lift those crank bars so we can chase after her.
It's true. The Murray is stronger than any mortal mind can comprehend. Alright, time to tap buttons. Listen, this is... All of my years of autistically tapping on things have,
Let's go!
have helped me with this moment right here, right now.
You lousy, no good head shrinker!
Oh, come now, Mari. We were making such progress during our sessions.
The only mental help that I need is to never be reminded of you again.
Yeah, got him.
Displaced hostility. If you insist on getting angry, why not be psychologically productive and channel it at your so-called friends?
I'm done talking with my mouth. Now I talk with my fists.
Oh, we're gonna get to beat the shit out of her? Time is up. How are they hurting me?
I guess we all share a health bar.
Oh, no! I thought you were getting away. Why are you waiting?
Okay, so you've got to beat the spider bomb before it detonates.
Ah, she's getting away.
Don't worry, pal. We'll find her. With the three of us back together, she doesn't stand a chance.
Hey. That's all she wrote. Well, other than this part.
It was great. The gang had been reunited and it was all because of me. Even the van ride out of town was like a party. Murray had to pull over twice because he was laughing so hard. But despite all the jokes, I think something had changed. Since childhood, the three of us had never been apart. And our recent isolation gave us all pause for thought. Needless to say, we took a few weeks off before getting back to work. And for the first time in my life, Murray let me drive.
Oh yeah. He's so proud. He got his license. Alrighty. Let me untangle my cables. Head back to my desk. There we go. Oh, my legs. Oh, I've been standing for so long. Alrighty. Well, that was exciting. It was fun. Did not hit 3 hours. I'm impressed. We got close, but we did not fully make 3 hours. So that's cool. Definitely ran longer than maybe it should have. I will start the stream earlier next time, I promise. Because I know that... I know that it took me a bit to get into it, but I was excited. I built some stuff for ProtoWeb. It was great. I still got to write the blog post for it. Tomorrow, that should be going up, so that's all good. I don't know who's still here other than Somnolescent, but if you are still watching, or if you're watching the VOD, I actually don't know who watches the VODs. Nobody ever comments on them, so who knows, you know? If you do happen to be watching on demand, thank you, and, you know, I very much appreciate. Yes, you're still here, Digital. Hello. Much appreciated chime in right at the end. And yeah, we will go for less time next time. Even though it was a good time. It was just it was a long stream, you know. But that's okay. I've had fun. Oh, Ryan is still here too. Excellent. And Kebby got to stay for the entire thing, although she is going straight to bed after this because it is motherfucking 3 AM.
and she's got school tomorrow. Yeah. Well, yeah. And the whole thing about it is like, I used to be exhausted by streams because they were such social work. And now I'm kind of like, oh, it's okay if I have an off stream. You know, who really is going to remember one off stream, whatever? And it really wasn't an off stream. So it's all good all around. Everybody's enjoying it. I watched Maruto at 3 a.m. Gone wrong, gone sexual, cops called. Or some shit. I don't know. But like I said, thank you guys very much for tuning in. It's always a good stream with you guys. And I do think that we are starting to get some people showing up more regularly, more recurring, which is very, very nice. So, I will see you back here next Sunday. We will continue the exciting adventures in Prague. It's a very good stream. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Thanks for watching. I will see you next week. I am going to go get some rest. And I hope you guys do too, because even if you're on the West Coast like me, the East Coast, it's still very late. But, yeah, thanks for watching.